Canoe Drexel University, presenting this year's Boat of the Cycle. First, we want to talk about our team management system for this year. We started off with a head project manager, along with an assistant project manager, who is a newer member. Next we'll go into our construction managers. We had two this year with our, we got new molds this year, so we required a lot of project management, or construction management, in order to build a new table. We had a mix manager who designed the mix each week during the testing phase, as well as a health and safety manager in order to ensure the safety of the members in the lab. Next, we have our general members and our advisors and consultants. Special thanks to Joseph Martin for being our head advisor. This year, we got new molds, as I mentioned. So we were able to look at previous year's molds and improve some flaws we saw. The big change being that now our molds and our canoe is asymmetrical from bow to stern. It has an overall length of 19 feet 7 inches, as well as a width of 29 and a half inches. The hull thickness we kept the same from last year, about a half inch, and we kept the color scheme the same. Or we used blue as our color scheme for our Poseidon. Testing results, as I said, we did many testing of different mixes, and these spread tests range from 18 to 26 inches. We also took four cylinders and broke four cylinders at 7-day, 14-day, and 28-day compressive strengths, and those results range from 1,500 to 2,100 pounds per square inch. Our final mix designs, you can see we have some cementitious materials and aggregates. The main change, I guess, from last year being silica, and also PVA fibers, we use the same as last year. Our admixtures are the same as well. We use viscose crete in order to use have the flowability of our mix, be able to go into the dual mold system, and we use a powder dye for our color.
So next I'll go through the construction of our canoe. Since this year, we got brand new molds. We restarted our working table. So first thing we did was strip off all the old materials, re-polyurethane the top of the table to protect the table as well as our new molds. Next, we made new support walls, which we then bolted into place on the table. As Andrew mentioned, we got brand new molds, and they come to a CNC machine out of styrofoam without any coating on them. So next, we applied two coats of epoxy to both the male and female molds. We then sand both molds so they are smooth. The male molds come in three different sections, and we need to seam them together, so we take out epoxy and glue them together, whereas the female molds stay separate. We then place the female molds within the support walls and tighten the walls up to the molds so they do not move, and then we suspend the male mold over top in preparation for pour day. We then use an assembly line type system to mix our cementation material and aggregates. On pour day, we made 4 1-cubic-yard mixes for quality assurance, and then we spread test each individual mix to make sure we have consistency throughout. Next, we take the mix and pour it into the female molds that are well oiled to make sure to allow for easy release. And then we lower the male mold, and we have alignment rods, as you can see in the picture above, to make sure we get the right thicknesses. We then bolt the male molds down to apply compressive stress down onto the concrete, forcing it to rise up through the mold and take the shape of the molds. At this point, we also place in our primary reinforcement, our steel mesh, so all the tensile strength at the top of the canoe. So after 4 days of curing with both molds in, we take the male mold out and start the curing process. We do this utilizing burlap and sprinkler system. And after 4 days of that system, we take the female molds out. We then place the flotation tanks. This year we took new styrofoam and shaped it to perfectly match the dimensions of the ends of our canoe. We then enclosed the flotation tanks with the same concrete mix, allowing it to sit for a while before we work in it so it stiffens it up. And then we apply our clear coat and our lettering, and then we have our final product. We'd like to thank you for attending our presentation, and we will now field any questions.
So,
of the weight comes from the bottom of the canoe. The bottom of the canoe is pretty thick. It's probably, like the engine said, it's a half an inch. Some places it's 3/4 inch. We do take measures. We have considered that, but we like to keep the thickness at the bottom so it doesn't reduce the amount of pressure. We, you know, like Andrew said, we have some mixes every year to go through that, and that's something we'll take into consideration for next year.
First, cracking. I noticed on your canoe there's some areas where you can see the cracking on both sides of your canoe. Do you see any concerns with that, or do you try to take any measures to correct
that? So we did see concerns with that. Some of those cracks actually happened during the transportation process getting out over here, but some also occurred during curing, and we also have to play with the curing. As Jerry said, we released it. We released the manhole 4 days after, and the fuel manifold also 4 days after that. So we for next year, we're going to play with the releasing times, how long each mold has to sit for the concrete to cure.
Did you do
any
testing this year to determine those, that 4 days and that extra 4 days?
We did not this year.
So your mold system is very complicated and really just doesn't leave a lot of room for error. Each year, how do you sort of weigh the pros and cons of the uniqueness of the system versus the significant risks associated with it?
So it was from 2000 to 2012, Drexel used the toll mold system, and then they got away with it. We went back to the system a few years ago. So we're still playing with it. A lot of last year, both cracked significantly to the point where we epoxied it, so it looked great while we were just looking at the competition. This year, we took a lot of more like quality control provisions, like ribbing. We ribbed all the female molds to make sure they kept their shape, and also trying to really make sure that that male mold couldn't go too far down to make sure our wall thickness was thick enough. So that's like one of the things we're doing every year is, you know, making sure that thickness is the right thickness, and it definitely pays off. Our system is very efficient. We don't take a lot of time making our canoe, and there's not a lot of finishing time either.
Yeah, and most of our time spent was aligning and constructing the molds. Aligning is really the main thing to get that thickness.
How do you, with the dual molds and the self-consolidated concrete, how do you know when you're constructing the canoe that you make sure that there are no void spaces and that the self-consolidated concrete has filled up the entire canoe?
So after we pour the canoe and we squish the male molds down, most of the concrete flows over the top, so we clean that off, and also we have mallets and we bang around the entire the table and the walls to try to help get those air bubbles out. We try to get it as much as we can, obviously, so stay in the bottom, but that's our main tool.
And we try to make sure that when we pour the concrete in, it's at the bottom, so it always works its way up, so we don't have a lot of air problems.
In terms of that vibration that you're adding to it, have you done testing of that? Only because, you know, the amount of space that the air can even propagate up through
is
so
very small.
So small.
So we, for each mix design, we always make sure to, when we're making cylinders, obviously I guess is a more, the ratio is higher for the air to get out, but we make sure to bang the sides, and that's basically all we do.
We used it last year and didn't have many problems, and I'm sure they've used it in the past. That's just one of the things that we carry over.
Yeah, another thing we did is last year, I think 2 years old last year, we made sure we got fresh lubricant this year. So.
It looks like you put that on the same day as you poured.
Yeah, we put it on about like 20 minutes before we pour, so make sure it's completely covered.
I did notice
So that is the wax, actually. So the female molds are not epoxied together as the male mold is in one piece. So in order to combat and seal it up, we use wax to seal it. And we, but during the curing, it got stuck in.